kissing at number three. I believe, just through common sense, that three is in everything you see. There are three primary colors: red, blue, and yellow. There's three stages of heat: hot, warm, and cold. Three, the magic number. Three is what we, with stoplights. I'm trying to think of what we were just talking about with the three, the significance of three. I know we were talking about that, but it was a bigger significance. Oh, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. We were talking about the whole purpose of life. See, there's a lot of different distinctions between why we're here. People always ask, what's the meaning of life? Why are we here? It's simple. In my opinion, that's my reality. Whatever your belief or your core theory is, that's your reality, that's your truth. And if your truth coincides with other people, then that's where you're born. You form a union, and then that's how people live in a community or so-called community environment, where everybody's belief is everybody's truth, which is everybody's life. So mine is, get all that dog that you got. Three, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Mind, body, and soul. The goal of life, to me, is to get back to God. In my opinion, God, if we're created in His image, and it would only make sense that if He's like us in body, then we're like Him in mind and spirit as well. So if that's the case, think about it. When we're bored, we ain't got nothing to do. We want some action. So if God created us and everything was good, then there had to be something for Him to do. And that means there had to be some destruction or some chaos for in order to be fixed. So He gave this planet, this part that we're in right now, that we live as human beings, as quote unquote the devil's realm. We're His place. So He can see all that is good kind of go under deconstruction, so that He can put the under construction sign up. So the under construction sign, part of us being here is that our job is to get back to Him and see what we can do with this playground He gave to quote unquote Lucifer. Now, I got a poem later on about Lucifer and that whole thing about him giving him his own office. Well, anyway, the goal of life is to get back to God. Now, we know, you know, when we say earth to earth and ash to ash and dust to dust and all that, the body itself goes back to God. If God created the earth and we're from Him and all the biblical, you know, theories and whatnot and beliefs, that makes sense. But what about the spirit? What about the mind? Now, if the mind is a substrate, if you will, or a subcomponent of the mind, then we can assume the mind dies with the body. But if the mind is the conduit to the spirit through the body, i.e. you burn yourself and your mind tells you, hey, that's hot, and then somebody tells you, hey, hell is hot, then that would suggest that you would do everything in the mind to cause the body to move toward giving the spirit a less hotter place than hell, if hell is as hot as that stove was that you touched. So, getting back to God in all three means you have to do something so that your spirit goes back to Him, which means your mind has to be in the mind state of all that is God. So if God is good and God is great, thank you for the food on my plate, then that suggests, and that's what you learn as a kid, that you have to be good. Better than that, you have to be great. So in order to be great, you have to understand your greatness as a component or a product of God. So you're your own God in your own world. Not a demigod or a false god or an idol, but you have to idolize yourself as a junior god, so to speak, to be great. If you just go through life doing good deeds and your character effort is overpowered by your personality ethic, then everything you do good is for nothing because you're doing it for you. And you might, yeah, you might donate to your church, donate to your local community centers, donate even to a politician who you believe their platform is for the betterment of the community. But if you don't do anything yourself, or if what you're doing goes against the community, like you sell dope, or you kidnap kids, or you do something like that that's outside of your kingdom, meaning your body, your mind, your space, your dwelling, what you control, not somebody else. If you're doing something like that, but yet on the side you tutor kids, but only to get them so you can molest them, then you know that's fucked up. But that's all for your own personal good. You can't do one thing and think that's gonna outweigh all your bad shit. Your perception of even the quote-unquote bad shit you do has to be for a good reason, or a reason that's not just good for yourself, but it has to go to your character, of what God's character would want you to be if you truly know what God's character is. So let's say it is good and it is great. Let's go to the food on your plate. Again, you got three rhymes. God is good, God is great. Thank you for the food on my plate. Three rhymes again, a magic number. So that goes to, what do you put in your body that helps it give a proper signal from what it receives to the mind, which in turn gives a better or more accurate perception of quote unquote reality in general to the spirit. So, for example, if you eat bullshit all day, drink soda, eat candy, eat sugar, don't exercise, and don't do anything, imagine the signal your body is giving your mind when your body ain't working right of what's going on around you, that you now use as your core belief to build your truth. So now, because the body's messed up, it can't process the input from your environment properly, and your mind is probably messed up because it's a part of your body, so it's not processing perception properly. And now it's feeding your spirit bullshit. So now you go around saying fuck God or whatever, or like, oh, I'll deal with that when I die. Well, I didn't know you're gonna die. I didn't know you just gonna come back. Having to do this all over again until you finally get it right. We don't know.
How we gonna get this map today without getting blasted away? I wake up to the same problems after the day. Life is harsh. Nigga got a bright spark. Right through the start. She placed me in the ghetto, tender age of 9. I'm a tender mind, had to surrender to crime.